6:38, we check back in now with Mike Eppel over at 680 News with the latest on business news. You are saying prepare yourself accordingly. There could be an interest rate hike coming up next week.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to start 2018, Tammy, with a tightening of monetary policy, a borrowing cost increase by the Bank of Canada. That's the talk this morning. All of the big banks forecasting that a week from tomorrow, our central bank will be raising its overnight lending rate by another 0.25% after two rate hikes in 2017. This is going to have a ripple effect again on the real estate market. It comes after some very strong economic statistics on job creation. The business outlook survey released by the Bank of Canada yesterday said a lot of Canadian companies are dealing with constraints just finding eligible workers, skilled workers. So there's a possible need to maybe hit the brakes just a little bit here, even though inflation remains low and the NAFTA negotiations remain outstanding. Toronto stock market didn't hit a record high in Monday's trade, but we did see those high-flying pot stocks hit all-time highs again. That sector was red hot in 2017 and has not slowed down at the start of the new year, with companies such as Canopy Growth and Aphria and Aurora Cannabis up double digits on a percentage basis. And some of these companies have market values of upwards of $8 billion in a sector that, again, saw a lot of momentum in 2017 and continues that with the legalization of weed and many U.S. states and coming here to Canada. Wall Street set records again Monday, including the shares of Amazon, as investors continue to pump money toward that company with the very strong sales results over the Christmas holidays. The overall mood of the market this morning is pretty positive again. It just continues this momentum play where Wall Street hits record upon record. GoPro, meantime, this was the darling on the market a few years ago when it debuted. The high-end camera company announced it's cutting jobs. It saw its revenue drop as competitors with cheaper products have flooded the market for GoPro. GoPro shares down below $7 now. At one point, they were close to $100. And Kevin, quick update on cryptocurrencies this morning, because Bitcoin yesterday dropped by 14%, down another 2% so far this morning. Others such as Ripple and Litecoin and I don't even know how to pronounce this one. Dogecoin. Doggy coin. I don't even know what that.
They sound all very
yesterday and down today.
They sound very reputable. Very reputable.
I saw a name and throw it out a coin.
I saw a debate this weekend on one of the news shows about Bitcoin. One author had written a long article op-ed about it, about how it's just a Ponzi scheme. And so the debate rages on whether or not these are really the future.
The thing that's got to happen here is there are 1,200 of these things. You got to figure out how they're actually being used. Is it just people getting in because the price goes up, therefore they don't want to miss out the FOMO trade? Is it something that is a tangible asset? And the debate rages on.
It's the old swampland in Florida I have for sale debate from years ago.
At least it's warmer there.
Thank you, sir.